Exclusive interviews with Michael Jackson's parents, Joe and Catherine. A film crew was making a documentary with the Jacksons when the sensational news broke of Michael's arrest on charges of child molesting. But instead of stopping the project, the Jacksons said, let's go on. For the next hour, Mr. and Mrs. Jackson tell how they reacted to the news that their superstar son was in handcuffs and the police were setting bail at $3 million. They talk of the toll fame has taken on Michael and on their other sons and daughters. We'll go inside Michael's home, Neverland, for a family birthday party and hear of the Jacksons' fears for Michael's own children, Prince, Paris and Prince Michael II, children who've only ever been seen in public wearing masks. Speaking to journalist Daphne Barak, Jackson's parents tell how they reacted to this latest controversy surrounding our son, Michael Jackson.
I was in Vegas and I heard the news. I just didn't like what was going on, so I had to try to get to him to really find out how was he taking it.
The service of the warrants was part of an ongoing investigation alleging criminal misconduct on the part of Michael Jackson.
I was getting ready to go to my Bible study at the Kingdom Hall, my book study, and someone said, turn the TV on. And I turned on the TV and there people were making these accusations about Michael. I just couldn't go. And I just sat down and say, not again.
First thing he said, don't worry, I'm strong like you. And so I knew that he was really meaning exactly what he said.
You know, he was strong and he said, Mother, don't worry. It's not the truth. You know, they can't do anything about, you know. It's not, but I told him, you don't know these wicked people. The people are just mean and wicked. I know it's not the truth, but what can you do when they can just, and then they'll tarnish your reputation, and people will always remember you the way they said he was, not the way he really is. I just hug him, and you know, you know how mothers are. They cry and all that, so I don't want to cry now because I don't want to talk about too much, because it's just sad the way they're doing him, and it's not right. He's stronger than I am about it.
I didn't think that what they did to him by putting handcuffs on him when he went to turn himself in, took his plane, and he flew to Santa Barbara, and they had to handcuff him. But to show you, you've seen when they had the handcuffs, he held the hand up so you can see the handcuffs on him. He's strong like that. There was no reason to do that, yeah. They just wanted to show the press that he had arrested Michael Jackson.
Mr. Jackson has been booked into the county jail. He has since been released. He has posted the bail, and he has been given an arraignment date of January 9th, 2004, at 8:30 a.m. in Santa Barbara Superior Court.
Some people are trying to accuse him of being a pedophile. That is not true. And they need to stop. And they need to stop saying he paid off the first thing and he's not going to get away with it again. That is not the truth either.
I am not guilty of these allegations, but if I am guilty of anything, it is of giving all that I have, all that I have to give to help children all over the world.
They know he hasn't done anything. The very first time, it was conspiracy for money. Michael had a gag order on him. He couldn't talk about it. And why would they want to put a gag order on him? If he did it, you know he wouldn't talk about it. But they know that he didn't. And I don't know, you're not a mother, I'm sure. Are you a mother?
Not yet.
Okay.
And you're doing it.
Well, I don't know, whoever is a parent, if someone came and molested your son, would you ask him for money? Would you? You can't answer me? No, you wouldn't ask them for money, would you? The first thing you would do was beat their behind, beat them up real good, and then you would call the cops on them, wouldn't you? This was a conspiracy.
Did you try to warn your son not to hug a kid inside a closed door? Because who knows what kind of allegation I might have.
No, it's nothing. You can hug a kid behind a closed door. Well, there's nothing wrong with hugging a kid or nothing. But they so, I don't know what you call it here in America, You can't hug a kid, you can't spank him or nothing. And yet and still, those kids that, what they don't lie you to do things to, they get into trouble, a lot of trouble. So you should be able to hug a kid and talk with him. You see that happens in the streets, you see people walking with kids. And sometimes they have their arm around them, walking, talking to them. But there's nothing wrong with it. You can twist anything when you want to. The media, they can twist anything they want to. Don't care if they don't like you, they're going to try to fix it so you can fall down with it.
Michael is here. He's come back specifically to confront these charges head on. He is greatly outraged by the bringing of these charges. He considers this to be a big lie. He understands the people who are outraged, because if these charges were true, I assure you Michael would be the first to be outraged. But I'm here to tell you today, and Michael has given me the authority to say on his behalf, these charges are categorically untrue.
They're talking right now that there would be an attempt to take his kids from him. You're not going to sit around.
We're not
going to
let nobody take those kids. They're Michael kids. They has no right to try to take those kids. It's going to be a big mess over that.
But I don't want to think like that. I don't want to think that, because that would be really mean for them to do, just take his children from him like that for nothing. It's not right. They're just trying to humiliate him.
Mm-hmm.
It's not right. Not right at all.
What are you going to do as a grandmother?
I hope they don't try to take his children. That would be devastating to him. But if they do, I'll be right there.
Would you try to adopt them?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Now, just to make this very clear, if, God forbid, things are going a bit wrong, you and Kate are going to say, we are going to take the kids and raise them until Michael is finished.
That's what we will do.
And you can do that?
Of course we can do that. We know what we can do, yes, of course.
And you're determined to do it?
Uh-huh. They're my grandkids. I have to.
There are mean, vicious people out there. And, you know, I think they might have had, I shouldn't say this because I don't know, but just because he loved children, this is the only thing they could get him on.
There we go, we got him.
It was kind of tough to hear all that type of news coming over the networks. The plane headed out. Jermaine was supposed to be on that plane, and myself, and Catherine. So I said, well, there's another way you get there. I'm going to take, we had this driver with the car. I said, since we got to go back to L.A., we just drive down. Michael's on his way back, you know. He was back in Vegas before we got to L.A. Yeah.
So you actually meant to show family solidarity to come with him,
mm-hmm.
And then the handler just got away.
Yeah, he's got away, yeah.
Oh, my God!
You're his father, and why do you have to go through handlers to talk to him? I mean, did you ever discuss it with him? Because I'm sure he loves you.
Well, they threaten him a lot with a lot of things that I don't know about. And also, we call it divide and conquer. So they try to keep a distance between him and I, or him and his mother and I. But sometimes I break through those barriers and get upset, and I just do it anyway, you know. But, hey, that's the way it is that with the people that's around him.
Now, at least the good news, if we can say, last time when it happened, LaToya was going in this press conference in Tel Aviv and saying horrible things about her brother. This time she is back to the family. Tell me, she's supportive?
Very supportive, and she was supportive before. See, what happened last time, maybe people don't remember, but when LaToya came on and did her first news conference, no, she said, my brother wouldn't do a thing like that. If they can run that back, you'll hear her. But after that, it was all different.
This is very difficult for me, that Michael is my brother, I love him a great deal, but I cannot and I will not be a silent collaborator of his crimes against small innocent children. And if I remain silent, then that means that I feel the guilt and the humiliation that these children are feeling, and I think it's very wrong.
She was with a mean, vicious, wicked man, and he knew. And he's on television the other day saying some ugly things.
I was Michael's brother-in-law. I stayed at that house often, and I stayed there for more than a couple of years. I saw and witnessed a lot of small little boys. I never saw a little girl. And I used to ask the question, why are there all little boys here, and there are no little girls? I never got an answer. I used to ask Latoya, I would ask Janet, Michael, Joseph, Catherine, and nobody ever responded to that question.
He never met Michael. He never stayed here in this house. No. And here in this house. And he doesn't know he's lying. And he knows he's lying. And this is what he did to my daughter. He actually had her afraid of me by brainwashing her.
He's running around, getting on TV, talking about he never stayed here at this house here. He never met Michael. Matter of fact, if he met Michael, I don't know what lot of happened. He might get a left hook as strong as Michael is. Yeah.
At the end of the day, it's about evidence. Where's the evidence? Yeah, I know he got plastic surgery. I know he may not be what you consider to be the guy next door, but where's the evidence? I'm a fan. I support him 100 zillion percent. Until I see evidence, I'm not going to be convinced. I'm not going to be brainwashed. You know what I mean?
I feel offended for him. You know what I mean? I feel offended by the way that the media is handling a man who really has been a major force in American culture since the day that he was born virtually. You know what I mean? And I really think that he deserves much more respect than he's getting right now. So I really hope that all of this kind of settles over, and I hope the truth comes to light. I believe the truth is going to come to light. You know what I mean?
Knowing Michael as a father, I know that he doesn't do things like that. His mother knows it too.
People just misrepresent Michael when they say these ugly things about him. He loved children. We used to sit up and watch television, and they show all the poor children around the world. You've seen those Feed the Children things on television. These children were so sick, flies flying all around their mouth, and all of that, and he'd sit there and tears would come in his eyes.
He was the smallest at that time, and he was fast, you know, he could move real fast on stage, and I thought this would be great, because he was all over the place. Matter of fact, Michael, you used to couldn't keep him still at all. He was always dancing or moving, you know. But when he came into the picture, my mother says, you know, he should be the leading.
He rocks in the teacup all day long. Happy mama, that's singing his song. I go to bed with a jabber steed. Now near the rhyme and go tweet, tweet, tweet. Rock your heart and toe.
Is any of them dancing or singing or trying to follow Michael's footsteps?
Not yet.
Do you want them to?
Well, if it's going to cause them as much pain as it caused Michael, I'd rather them not.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not deserving to Michael, and I imagine I don't want him to have to go through that. You know, some people say the more children you have, the easier it is. That is not the truth. They're all difficult to give birth to, but once they get here, it's a joy.
From the United States, from Motown, the young record stars, the Jackson 5.
Michael was growing up, he didn't call you Pa or Daddy, he called you Joe, right?
Right.
Did you want it, or because he was so respectful? I mean, how?
Well, I didn't too much care because he knew and I knew that he was my son and I was his father. Well, what I got a kick out of Michael is when he was small, is when I would give him his allowance, he would have these kids sitting around feeding them, you know. He loved to help. You know, he can't say no. Anybody wants something from him, he would give it to them and cry later about it, but he let them have it, yes.
People just misrepresent Michael when they say these ugly things about him. He loved children. We used to sit up and watch television, and they show all the poor children around the world. You've seen those Feed the Children things on television. These children were so sick, flies flying all around their mouth and all of that, and he'd sit there and tears would come in his eyes. And he'd say, one day I'm going to do something about this. This was when he was very young. And, he was a teenager. He said, I know I can't heal the world, but I can help.
This time, I'm going to do my best to make it right. And go on without you by my side. Hold on, shelter. Come and rescue me out of this storm. And out of this cold, I need someone. Oh, hold on. Why?
You know, people keep thinking that the family is separate, but that's not true. What happened was I had arranged with making dates for Africa. I was going to tour all over Africa with my boys because they had said they were going to send a plane here and I wanted the J-5 on the plane and all that stuff. So, you know, to show it off a little bit, that's promotion anyway. Send a plane from Africa to pick up the Jacksons. It didn't work. Somebody talked Michael out of it, and we didn't get a chance to pull it off. From that point on, they started setting other dates up for Michael doing the same Jackson's shows that what the brothers was doing.
You know what? I always felt that there wasn't any jealousy, and the children was happy for Michael. They would be excited when his record go number one. And during that time, most of them were grown. Except Janet and Randy, they were still young, but they were teenagers, I imagine, but they all was happy for him.
Michael was doing his own thing, and the other Jackson was writing songs with different people, I guess. But Michael was still going on. That's what separated him from the rest, because of people talking, you know. They probably told him, I'm not for sure of this, but I'm saying what they probably told him, that he could make more money just by touring himself. You don't have to slice the pie, that those many slices, you know.
Tell him this for me, all I need is
one more chance and love. One more chance and love.
One more.
One more chance and love. One more chance.
One more chance for love. Why? I tell the seven seas to be near her, and if the heavens see her, see, tell her this for me.
Since the day he started singing, he was just going uphill. I mean, we knew that the success would be all over the world because it never stopped. It just stopped climbing and climbing and climbing with it. There's a lot of entertainers in the world, but they know a lot of entertainers can do a show. They just get up there and sing. You have to have them both going. You have to be able to do your singing and also be able to have a show with that singing. And that's Michael. If you notice, his show is just as good as his singing, yes.
How would I describe Michael? He is shy. Most of the children are shy. I can just name a few that's not, but most of them are shy. He is funny with us around the family, but I don't know how he is around, you know, other people.
Funny, like talking, making jokes?
Making jokes and teasing,
mm-hmm.
and all that. Loves to dance. We know that already. To sing, to write songs, read lots of books. Always working, always doing something, always busy. And if you pass a room and we're watching TV, and he'll stick his head in the door, how could you? The world is passing you by and you're sitting there watching TV. And this is what he says when he looks in the room, and because he's busy all the time, writing songs or doing something.
He has helped so many people, grown people, kids. He gives to all kind of charities and things that never hits the news. And that's the only thing I worry about, because no one never knows how much he does.
He formed Neverland mainly because it's always been his dream to help children. And he lets so many children come out, underprivileged children. The school teachers bring their classes out there, the children dying. The Make-A-Wish Foundation, to name just a few. I remember that when they were looking for a ranch, and I mentioned to Bill Bray, who was looking for him too, that the ranch that we had gone out to when Paul McCartney did Say, Say, Say with Michael, and I told him that's a really nice ranch, and he always loved that ranch. And when he found out it was for sale, then he came and told us, I got it, you know, I'm buying it. And I was happy for him because he was happy too. He loves a ranch. Jackie lives on a ranch right now. It's a small one. But Janet loves a ranch. Life, and they all do.
I visited there before Michael ever came ownership of the place. It was nice out there. I used to go out there and wander around. But it was nothing like what it is now. Michael has that place really decked out. Thank you, Michael, for letting me have my birthday party. All those people there at the ranch, at Neverland Ranch. It was fantastic, and I appreciate that. Appreciate it, Michael. Thank you very much.
I'm very happy to be here. It's my father's birthday, Joseph Jackson.
Happy birthday, Joe Jackson, from MC Hammer and family.
I see them about maybe once a month, and sometimes a little more regular, and sometimes not as regular because he travels a lot too with the children. But when I go, I used to take gifts all the time to them, and then Michael said, Mother, don't bring them any gifts. I don't want them to be expecting anything because they have enough, you know. But I just wanted to bring a gift because I was their grandmother.
Thank you, Michael, for letting me have my birthday party. All those people there at the ranch, at Neverland Ranch. It was fantastic, and I appreciate that. Appreciate it, Michael. Thank you very much.
the ranch, there's so much to do. So we had, well, we ate there. There was a big, big tent, and we ate and we had fun, and the kids would ride on the rides and, you know, and all of that. We saw movies, and then it was talent time.
Happy to be here. It's my father's birthday, Joseph Jackson.
Happy birthday, Joe Jackson, from MC Hammer and family.
What really gave me the idea of getting heavy involved with show business, if we want to have all these kids, they got to be able to do something in life, you know, because they all went to school and all that, but I'm still thinking about having them involved in show business. So after then, another kid was born. You know, I'm raising kids instead of writing songs, you know. But then after them, I had a whole group, you know. They came along, Michael. He rocks in the treetop all day long. I've been running that scene in song. I thought the band is on J. Bush Street. And then the rhyming go tweet, tweet, tweet. Rock your robin, oh, rock, rock. Michael came into the picture, the whole thing started changing because the harmony started fitting in. Catherine would work with him when I'm at work, you know, and when I got off from work, you know, still operating the crane, when I got off from work, I would rehearse them, sometimes 2 hours, you know. Everybody clap your hands.
Well, I was there with the children most of the time, and they used to sing in their bedroom together. And they would sing a lot of songs from the Temptations, and when they got really serious about singing, we used to sing together just as a family. When Joe would go to work, we'd just sing folk songs or sing together, but I heard him singing in the bedroom, singing one of the Temptation songs. You know, I can't even remember the song, but their harmony was so beautiful. And their sister, their older sister, Rebe, would stand by the door and listen with me, and she would start to cry because it was so nice.
For the joy!
For the joy!
For the joy! He was the smallest at that time, and he was fast, you know, he could move real fast on stage, and I thought this would be great, because he was all over the place. Matter of fact, Michael, you used to couldn't keep him still at all. He was always dancing or moving, you know, but when he came into the picture, my mother says, you know, he should be the leading. That they could win talent shows, and we rehearsed them so they could be the best.
Which one of your kids that is the most talented one?
Let me name you three. Right quick. It would be Michael. It would be Jermaine. And it would be Janet. I don't know whether you heard Jermaine sung the other night, but you see, he's really professional.
Jermaine Jackson, how's that for talent? One more time for Jermaine Jackson.
Can't help what they try to do to him already. He hasn't done anything to deserve this. He's the biggest entertainer in the world, and they don't like that. Believe me, they do not like that.
The world is wicked today. You can't change the things that you really want to change. What I would do is I'd make sure that they took time out to go to college. And that would be one of the things that I would change. And I wish they were a little more spiritual.
She's highly, highly upset because of the way Michael, the things he's going through with certain people out there. And she knows, you know, the difference. She knows exactly what they're trying to do. And that's why I say to the fans all over the world, Michael's fans and the family fans, to stick by the family and Michael, because he do not deserve what's going down with him now.
His own troubled upbringing and difficult relationship with his father, hidden by his breathtaking ability to dance and sing. The persistent allegations about his relationships with young boys, and the future of his own three children, whose lives are shrouded in mystery. They're never seen without masks. Catherine and Joe Jackson talk to interviewer Daphne Barak about how they think the world has treated their son, and they speak of their fears for their grandchildren.
The world is wicked today. You can't change the things that you really want to change. What I would do is I'd make sure that they took time out to go to college. And that would be one of the things that I would change. And I wish they were a little more spiritual than what they are, because they grew up going to the Kingdom Hall with me. And, you know, I can't make them because they're grown-ups now. But that's one of the things that I did what I could back then, I wouldn't change that because that's what they did.
I think I was a good father. I raised them and I fed them and kept plenty of clothes on them. We didn't have much, but what we had, we was happy with it, yes.
And what kind of father is Michael?
He's just that. He's a good father.
Is he strict with his kids, or is he, oh no, do whatever you want?
I don't think he's strict as I was, because during their time, when they would come up as kids, there was a lot of bad things happening around in the area, and I had to know what was going on, keep them out of trouble. Yes.
So he's more like?
He gives them a little bit of rope, you know, but he really watches over them. Plus, he has other people there, too, to watch him as well. You know, they have the nannies and things of that sort.
Is he affectionate? Are they hugging him? Are they, how do they call him? Daddy? Michael? How does
Daddy, and very affectionate. His children just love him. And he's a real good father, and people out here can stop it. Mm-hmm. They're just mean.
Did you talk to the kids? Are the kids aware of something wrong going
no,
on?
No, they don't even watch TV. They're not aware of it. They don't need that.
How did you pretend everything was fine?
Oh, the kids, they're just playing around, you know, playing with their little toys. And they were glad to see me, too. They ran up, hollering, Grandpa. They're so short, they grab me around my leg. They were glad to see me, the little girl and the little boy. Yes.
I see them about maybe once a month, and sometimes a little more regular, and sometimes not as regular because he travels a lot, too, with the children. But when I go, I used to take gifts all the time to them. And then Michael said, Mother, don't bring them any gifts. I don't want them to be expecting anything because they have enough, you know. But I just wanted to bring a gift because I was their grandmother.
Do they ever call you, telephone you, hi, grandmother, or something?
Yes. Yeah. When Michael called me, they can't wait to get on the phone. They always, Grandma, how are you? I just wanted to talk to you. And you know what? They always telling me things that they've done. And I drew a picture for you, or I made a boat for you. You know, these little paper boats and hats, and that's what they gave me when I left. They drew a picture, and they gave me a little hat they made and with the little paper.
Now tell me about the kids. Tell me about Prince. What kind of boy is he? Is he shy? Is he?
No, neither one. He's not shy, and I can see him being another entertainer in the Jackson family.
Here it goes again.
Yeah, it's another. So is the little girl, too. But Prince is very outgoing, and so is the little girl as well.
Do they have good voices?
Yes, the strong voices.
Are they dancing?
Oh, yes, they do their little dance and stuff. Around. Oh.
You already auditioned them?
No, I didn't audition. There's some things that they were doing in there. They watched their father, you know.
Oh, darling, I was blind to let you go.
Let you go, baby.
Now, since I see you in his eyes.
I want you back.
Yes, I do now.
I want you back.
Ooh, ooh, baby.
I want you back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I want you back.
Nah, 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 nah.
Is any of them dancing or singing or trying to follow Michael's footsteps?
Not yet.
Do you want them to?
Well, if it's going to cause them as much pain as it caused Michael, I'd rather them not.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not deserving to Michael, and I imagine I don't want him to have to go through that.
Kate looked very, very frail. She has.
Well, she's highly, highly upset because of the way Michael, the things he's going through with certain people out there. And she knows, you know. The difference, she knows exactly what they're trying to do. And that's why I say to the fans all over the world, Michael's fans and the family fans, to stick by the family and Michael, because he do not deserve what's going down with him now. And I'm speaking of everybody. Got support calls all over from different countries in Africa, in Europe, and all those places down in South America, every place, because the family is known internationally.
How have you been coping? You haven't slept, right? You haven't been sleeping?
No, I haven't been able to sleep in my butterflies in my stomach, and it's just mean. And then this mean man that took LaToya off, the same thing. People don't realize, and they don't care. That's what it is. They all want money. That when they're hurting someone else, they're hurting a lot of other people. He has a family, he has a mother and a father, and he has nieces and nephews that go to school, and children are very mean and say mean things. And it's just, we don't deserve this. We're good citizens, we treat everybody right. So why do we have to go through this? It's not right.
Michael can't help what they try to do to him already. He hasn't done anything to deserve this. He's the biggest entertainer in the world, and they don't like that. Believe me, they do not like that.